the President's remarks. From the Secretary's opening remarks, it was evident the people expected a regular campaign address, full of statistics and stories about the crusade, and when they saw that the subject was to be argued from a Bible standpoint, they were all at first astonished, then interested, and finally deeply moved. There was no smiling, no noisy applause. All seemed to feel that the subject presented was too solemn to excite merriment. At the close of the address, Dr. Neeson, president of the society, made a few pointed remarks, calling attention to the fact that the great prosperity of the temperance movement in America is due to its being supported by the religious zeal and Bible truth. He appealed most earnestly to parents to act upon the matter of training their children to temperate habits. After dismissing the audience, he introduced me to some of the leading temperance workers. Not a few came forward to greet me, shaking hands cordially and expressing their gratitude for having heard the discourse, saying they had never before listened to such a temperance lecture. An urgent desire was expressed that I should address them again, but I felt that our own people needed my help, and I must do all for them that was in my power.